As you all can see, the Council of Raoul Cerules have come out today to decide if French Flag Raoul is worthy to join their clan, or otherwise he will be exiled for forever and won't be able to even call himself Raoul Cerule anymore. So we're going to find out today, guys, if he is worthy, if he's accepted in by the end of the video. But very excited to get into this one. This is, of course, French Flag Raoul Cerule from the Cars Fast as Lightning mobile video game that unfortunately has been shut down as of the last few years. But nonetheless, we are keeping the memories alive. We are keeping the video game going by recreating the paint jobs that were exclusive to the characters in the game. They had some phenomenal ones. Of course, the older video games have had some great ones as well, including Cars 2, the video games, Francesco Bernoulli, this hot rod one with flames here that I reviewed a couple years ago. But this is the first time I've gotten a Raoul custom done. I kind of want to have one of every World Grand Prix racer when it's all said and done. And this is probably about halfway to that goal with Raoul here. And this custom was by Shane Cooper. Of course, he is my video game guy. Does great work. If you want to contact him about a custom, his contact info is in the description below. Contact him via Facebook or Instagram. So before we get into the review itself, I want to show you guys how French Flag Raoul looks in the video game. He is one of the three unlockable paint jobs, I believe it is, for the character. The other two being Ice Racers Raoul, which of course is this one right here. Pretty much a cop-out for the video game developers. Just put the Ice Racer one in there. We didn't have to really do much creative thinking on that one because it already was designed. And they did that a few times because the Ice Racers were kind of new and popular at that time. They also put some of the neon ones in the game as well. The game did not include anything past that though, like Carbon or Carnival Racers. And then the third paint job is probably the worst in the game. I think it's Viva La France. And it basically is just a naked Raoul Cerule. I don't know if I'll be able to find a good picture of it. If I do, you'll see it there. But it's basically just Raoul Cerule without any decals, without his like blue paint splatter that he usually has as well. It is the most boring thing I probably have ever seen in my entire life. I will never get that custom done. I probably could do it with some nail polish remover myself. So French Flag Raoul Cerule is definitely the choice to go with here. I don't even know why they decided to do two honoring France for him. Like, that's way overkill. They clearly, yeah, they screwed up Raoul. Like, they do not have many good options for him compared to some of the other characters who have multiple quality paint jobs. I mean, this is just one of them for Carla Veloso. She has another beautiful one in like orange. And most of them only have one paint job honoring the country they're from. Like, there's Spanish flag Miguel, there's Italian flag Francesco, there is Japanese flag Shutsutoroki, although I opted for this midnight version of him that looks way cooler. I don't think there is maybe a German flag version of Max Schnell, but again, not the coolest version they ever did. I think there is a German version. It's not like a German flag version. I don't think they did anything Brazilian though for Carlo Veloso. But anyways, we're not here to talk about them. We're here to talk about Raoul. And so Shane Cooper did use a Thailand version of Raoul. So we will get to that, but I just want to preface that right off the bat. The expression is incredible. You guys know I love when cars are looking off to one side or the other instead of looking dead on, which is what we're pretty much used to with Raoul and every other character. So this really is awesome. Gives him some added personality, a little bit of charisma. And it's not the first time we've seen Raoul with a expression that is looking off to the side. The metallic version from 2011, late 2011, exclusive only to European Toys R Us stores, I think it was, is looking off to the side. And then the carbon version is also looking off to the side. And that expression is pretty similar to the one on the custom, but still is quite a bit different. So it's a Shane Cooper original, which I absolutely love. And yeah, a simple paint job. It literally is the French flag just transposed onto his body. Blue, white, and red. pretty simple. Three stripes, hard to mess up, but Shane Cooper did a beautiful job with it. I mean, the expression is really what makes this one of my favorites here. So yeah, let's just keep on going. You can see his mouth is still painted, which is great because obviously he had the paint over that with the white there. So not really sure how he does all that, but he is the master. You got the headlights here. Nice wheels there, silver spokes. Just a nice red on the side. Of course, he painted the side view mirrors, which are separate plastic pieces that connect in from the inside. So keep that in mind. N48 is the base stamp here. So I think that's maybe like 2021. And yeah, you can see made in Thailand and all that. And he used some sort of like epoxy glue to get the car back together. And as I've talked about before, when you do customs like this and you have to take apart the entire vehicle to paint it properly, you have to drill out the rivets, of course, to disassemble it. And you don't necessarily always have like screws or rivets. I mean, most people don't have like a rivet machine to reassemble it. And so that is what most customizers do in that instance. I have seen screws before, but usually I would go with this epoxy. It seems to work the best. And of course, he also did the spoiler, the wing here, which is another separate plastic piece. And to have aligned it so perfectly in terms of the stripes there, you know, where the blue ends, the white starts, where the white ends, the red starts. Just a phenomenal job. I am so impressed with this custom. It just is so clean looking and beautiful. And even here, you can see the taillights on the back. Maybe not so much on that side, but you can see it on this side. It does look a little weird just having a red blotch on one side and not on the other side, but it is there. It is just blent in with the red. And you have his quadruple exhaust pipes. That's a part of the base. Just a gorgeous car altogether. This is the Thailand version again, so the windows are a part of the main metal body. And so the only plastic pieces really on the exterior here are the side view mirrors and the wing. Is easily my favorite version of Raul in my collection. Before that, it was probably the carbon version just because of the expression. And I love when they did these paint jobs that look so different from the original. I mean, seeing Raul in such a darker color was quite a bit jarring, but really cool. And he obviously had some nice wheels there, multicolored as well. I also really do like the carnival version of him, even though it is pretty basic. But again, you have the multicolored wheels. And this one was exclusive to a 4-pack. I'm trying to think. I remember my mom surprised me with this 4-pack. No, it was like, I think 2015. I think I had like a procedure done. I either had like my wisdom teeth removed or something kind of wild like that, where I came home and I was like, oh wait, never, I remember. I got this weird, weird disease. You guys are going to be like, what the hell is that? Mycoplasma. Yes, this was like February of 2016, I think it was. I remember it distinctly now, and I just came home from like a doctor's appointment. I felt like absolute crap, and voila, right there were the whole first wave of Carnival Racers, which was the 4-pack, and then I think a couple singles that were not included in that 4-pack, so like maybe that was Shoots, Hiroki, and Jeff. Can't quite remember. I think the 4-pack was Raul, McQueen, Francesco, and then one other racer, and then they also launched with Carla, Shu, Francesco, Jeff, and McQueen singles. I think that was everybody, and then later on they did the super rare second wave with Rip, Nigel Lewis, Miguel, and Max. So weird. So I only found that wave one time. I had to basically break some guy's finger in order for him to bring it out to the front. I remember also that one distinctly. Just kidding. I did not have to do any breaking of any fingers, but just a little story time in relation to Raul here. Good stuff all around, guys. This is a gorgeous custom, and yep, obviously one of my favorites. Also, when they moved to Thailand, they stopped doing this stupid mouth plate here in the front, even though this was a 2016 release, and they kind of stopped doing it before then on most cars. They still had it on this one. You could see the crack there in between the main metal body and the plastic bumper. But for some cars, they did stop it before 2016. It just not happened for Raul. So yeah. What do you guys think, Council of Raul's? Are we going to let French Flag Raul? Of course we are going to let him in, because he's better than all of you. I'm sorry, he just is. Of course, this was one of the first variations of him. It was actually, honestly, I think this is the third version of Raul they did. I'll tell you guys the first and second when we get to it. But yeah, Silver Raul, of course, exclusive to Kmart. And then later on in 2015, the Walmart, when they reissued him, the neon version came out after that in 2014. Pretty nice. They did change the expression to straight down the middle, a little bit more determined than what we had before, as you could see there. But still not my favorite because it is just the same decals as before. This was, I'm pretty sure, the second version of him. Of course, not including the original, which, like I said earlier, was exclusive to international stores, making him very, very rare. And yeah, very unfortunate that they didn't do all the World Grand Prix racers metallic, because it seems like they were going to go that way. And then they stopped after like three. They did McQueen, Francesco, Jeff, Miguel, and Nigel, and then Raul internationally. Yep, here you have the Carnival version again. This is just your regular version here. This is turning into a big Raul variations video. Not quite though, we will do that down the road. I remember I did a variations video on Raul way back in the day, but now we have a few more to add on top of it. Here's the carbon version again, which is my favorite behind French flag Raul. Both of them are elite. This is technically the first version of Raul they did after the original. It is from one of those puzzle play sets, and he has the silver stripe. So super obscure variants of him. Not many people probably know about it. If you do, pat yourself on the back. But yeah, it's basically like silver Raul, but diet, because he's only partly silver. And yeah, they did a few of those play sets, a McQueen, a Francesco, a Mater, and of course Raul out of the blue. Raul is kind of one of those weird characters where he's gotten a lot more attention than other World Grand Prix racers, even more than Carlo Veloso, Jeff, Lewis, ones that you think would be up there. Because what you won't see here today is the Color Changers version of him, which not only got a single release, but also a two-pack release. Very rare for both of those as well. And also, what's canceled for Raul? Oh yeah, the lights and sounds variation of him was canceled. So Raul could have been just absolutely dominant in terms of his presence. But, you know, the metallic version, the Color Changers version became super rare. Lights and sounds version got canceled. And he has had some other plastic versions. The Quick Change version of him. There was a Charge-Ups version of him as well. So he's been around the block, but we have not seen any newness out of Raul, unless you include like the 2020 Silver Thailand variant. Yeah, that's pretty much the last time we got anything new out of Raul. So here you have it, 2024. Raul is still vibing. I'm just trying to get so the glare is not in his eyes. Here we have Emmanuel Maniez, the Pity, and we have Bruno Motor, the awesome Citroën crew chief. Perfect model to use for a French racer's crew chief, if you ask me. But yeah, guys, let me know in the comments below, what is your favorite version at Raul? What do you think of this custom? I absolutely love it. I think, you know, Shane Cooper did a great job. However, I will say that he's done better jobs with other racers that were more challenging, and we will be getting to those. You guys might have an idea of who they are. Let me just say, you know, maybe a little Max Schnell, maybe even a little Longue action, maybe even a little Lightning McQueen from one of the original video games. There's a lot of great customs left to review. I think the next one will be the Motorco Racer, though, which is a big deep cut. You guys might know what that's referring to. If not, you'll find out. All right, as per usual, thanks for watching, your support. I'll see you guys next time. Bye now. But when it all burned down and you were left with nothing, did you question God or did you see it coming? Come on.